Welcome back to the online sessions on fuzzy logic and its applications. And now we will be starting last unit, that is unit number 5. So we have covered until 4 units. And in this, before we start up the exact contents of unit number 5, because unit number 5 is simply going to be based on the applications of the fuzzy logic. So that means what the one of the greatest applications of fuzzy logic is going to be done or implemented in the fuzzy control system. So therefore, and using fuzzy control systems, we normally going to develop so many fuzzy memory units. So therefore, first of all, we'll try to cover this particular fuzzy control system. So before we go into chapter 5, let us have a gist of the topics that we have covered in the earlier chapters, that is chapter number 1, 2, 3, and 4. So in first chapter, we covered with the fuzzy sets and basics of fuzzy set representation. And second unit, we covered on the operations of fuzzy sets. Third unit, we covered on the fuzzy various membership functions of the fuzzy system, fuzzy logic, and we covered on the fuzzification, and fourth unit we covered on the defuzzification methods. So let us try to just have a gist of all those things over here in this session, and then we enter into the unit number 5 with the control systems. So now let us look into this fuzzy logic. So fuzzy logic supports machine learning technique. So whenever we want to design any system which supports machine learning, so we normally develop that system by using fuzzy logic. So therefore, fuzzy logic supports machine learning technique. It supports mimicking the logic of human thoughts. Logic may have two values and represent two possible solutions. Usually this fuzzy logic is normally meant to provide multi-valued results. So as it provides multi-valued, it definitely going to, you know, supports two values as well. So fuzzy logic is a multi-valued logic and allows intermediate values to be defined. Intermediate values means what? Let us suppose we are looking for discrimination between cold and hot. If it is cold, how much it is cold? If it is hot, how much it is world hot? That means what? So many intermediate values will be considered to call it as a cold or very cold or chilled or whatever it is. And hot is going to be warm, very hot, hot. Okay, like this, so many values will be coming for a hot water to be taken into consideration, so which is called as intermediate values. So fuzzy logic is a multi-valued logic and allows intermediate values to be defined. So this is possible, as we discussed, by using the different membership functions. Provides an interference mechanism which can interpret and execute the commands. Fuzzy systems are suitable for uncertain and approximate reasoning type of systems. So uncertain systems, fuzzy logic can be used. And appropriate reasoning also, fuzzy logic can be normally used. Okay. So other things are going to be, now let us have a comparison. Fuzzy logic is going to be, as we discussed, it's going to be multi-valued kind of a system. Whereas bivalued is the one which we discussed earlier in the binary logic, where it provides two values, either 0 or 1, yes or no, right or wrong. Okay, yes or no, like this. So many values will be coming for, you know, bivalued function or a binary logic systems, which we discussed in the STLD subject, switching theory logic design, or a DLD subject, digital logic design subject. Now, fuzzy logic can be multi-valued. That is what the difference here. It can have a relative values like yes, not, not so much, little bit, okay, so on and so forth. So like that, so many values can be coming here. Say, are you young? A question is asked. So for this, so many answers can come. So definitely I'm an young person. Why not? I'm an young person. So on and so forth. So many things, really, so many intermediary values can come for an young person to be called as an young. Okay. Any person whose age is going to be between 18 and 40 is going to be called as a young person, say for example. So many intermediate values can really exist for a person to be called as a young person. So like that, these fuzzy systems or fuzzy logic systems are normally meant to provide multi-valued outputs or multi-valued results. And next, what are the various characteristics of fuzzy logic? Exact reasoning is viewed as a limiting case of the approximate reasoning. So we can normally try to get an exact reasoning by applying limiting cases to the approximate reasoning. So we apply some limiting cases to approximate reasoning and we try to go to the exact values. Say for example, a thermometer reading, it is showing a value of say something like 96.767. So I can approximate this to 96.8. So that is what, you know, we are applying a limiting case to the approximate reasoning value to reach to the exact reasoning value. So everything is a matter of degree in the case of fuzzy logic. That is what one of the characteristic, that means associativity is the one which is very important or plays a predominant role. So how far a particular value is associated to the functionality, that is what we is going to speak about in the case of the fuzzy logic. To signify its characteristic, important thing is that matter of degree, or I can say how close it is nearer to the required value or an exact value. That is a matter of degree. Knowledge is interpreted as a collection of elastic and equivalently fuzzy constraints and a collection of variables. So this fuzzy logic is totally based on the knowledge which is interpreted as a collection of elastic and equivalently fuzzy constraints and a collection of variables. It is a knowledge interpreted from a collection of variables is one of the characteristic, and inference is viewed as a process of propagating the elastic constraints. So the constraints are going to be varied based on the varying reasoning. So therefore, inference is simply viewed based on the process of this propagating elastic constraints. So any logical system can be fuzzified. So any multivariate logical system can be simply fuzzified. Okay. So in this process, we have defined a fuzzy set from a crisp set, which is defined or characterized by its membership functions called mu. To define a fuzzy set X, which is normally going to have two values called 0 and 1. And between these two values, how far and this mu A of X is normally going to signify the degree of membership of the element X in the fuzzy set A for each of the element X belongs to X. In this process, we discussed about a crisp set, crisp logic, crisp set, fuzzy set, and fuzzy logic. Okay. So here, this is what one of the example of the fuzzy set, which defines many values of the temperature of a water. So if the temperature of a water is going to be, you know, less than this value, say this value is going to be computed to be of around, say, 7. If it is less than 7, it is going to be cold. If it is more than 7, up to 20, it is going to be called as cool water. So like that, we normally going to have different associations or different degrees of belongingness of the temperature with respect to cold and warm waters. So for example, cold is 0, hot is 1. So now how far it is cold, how far it is hot, how far it is close to 0, how far it is close to 1. That means here we normally represent this by simply representing by a curve, representing a mathematical function, which is nothing but, which is defined by a membership function. It determines the degree of belongingness of the member X to the fuzzy set T. So that means, I think you're understanding, because already we have discussed all this. So we are simply defined about the fuzzy set by its membership function, which signifies about its belongingness Okay, so it signifies about its belongingness, or it specifies the degree of the associativity. Okay, so this is what the representation of the fuzzy set that we can represent by using a triangular membership function. So in general, what is the definition of a fuzzification? So fuzzification is the process of transforming input values which are bivalued, are simply called as something like exact values or something called as crisp values, into linguistic variables or values is called fuzzification. So fuzzification is the process of transforming crisp input values into linguistic values is called as fuzzification. We have discussed about various steps involved in fuzzification. The first step is input values are translated into linguistic concepts or linguistic values, which are represented by fuzzy sets. So these linguistic values are simply represented by fuzzy set. So after we get a fuzzy set, membership functions are applied, like triangular function, trapezoidal function, Gaussian function. So membership functions are applied to the measurements, and the degree of membership is simply determined. So after we determine the degree of membership, then we simply going to get the fuzzy values. And a fuzzy system is a system which is normally going to process these fuzzy values. So third step is simply going to be a fuzzy system which is normally used to process this particular fuzzy values is the third step in applying the fuzzy method. Next one is defuzzification, is reverse of fuzzification. It converts, defuzzification converts fuzzy values into the crisp values. So this defuzzification is nothing but reverse of the fuzzification process, where we convert the fuzzy values into the crisp values or bivalued data. Now we have discussed about various methods of defuzzification, using which we have converted fuzzy values into the crisp values. So the methods we discussed in the last sessions, that is unit number 4, are going to be maximum membership method, centroid method, weighted average method. Okay, so in maximum membership method, remember the maximum value has been chosen. This method chooses the elements with maximum value. Centroid means what? This method finds the center point of the targeted fuzzy region that you are looking to have a value by calculating the weighted mean of the output fuzzy region. Then next we discussed about weighted average method, assigns weights to each membership function in the output by its respective membership values. So using these methods, we normally converted the fuzzy values to the crisp values. So that is a very small chapter. Chapter 4 is very small because it contains altogether 6 methods. So you should undergo all these 6 methods in the defuzzification process. Okay, so please practice these 6 methods. One of the method will be definitely going to come in the short answer as well as in the long answer questions. And after that, we performed in unit number 2 various operations on fuzzy sets. So operations such as union operation, complement operation. Remember, union means what? If these two are the two fuzzy sets, so we just simply going to join these two fuzzy sets. By joining these two, we normally going to get this kind of a fuzzy set. And complement means what? 1 minus a of x we have performed, which is the complement of the given fuzzy set we discussed. Then equality of two fuzzy sets. Okay, and this we don't have in the syllabus. Quasi fuzzy membership is not in the syllabus. Let us go back to the next one, that is triangular types of fuzzy functions. So fuzzy values are computed by using fuzzy functions. So we discussed about triangular fuzzy function. We discussed about trapezoidal fuzzy function. Okay, and Gaussian fuzzy functions, right? The next concept is simply going to be the linguistic variables. So a variable whose values are words are sentences in natural language. That means the variables are treated as words or sentences in a natural language like English or any other language for that matter. So for example, temperature is a linguistic variable. If it takes values hot, cool, warm, comfortable, etc., so this is simply going to be a linguistic variable. So the framework of a linguistic variable is given as something like capital X, LX, okay, and X, mu X, etc., where X, capital X denotes a symbolic name of linguistic variable. This capital L, small x, is a set of linguistic values that X can take, and this second form of X, that is a second form of X symbolic representation here, is the linguistic form of X, is the physical domain that defines the crisp values. Physical domain crisp value, that is what it describes the descriptive values of the crisp values. Mu of X is the fuzzy membership function that maps the linguistic terms of the variable to its equivalent crisp values. Then fuzzy propositions, we discussed like conjunction, disjunction, implication, negation, all this we discussed as a fuzzy propositions. So this fuzzy proposition is a statement that drives a fuzzy truth value. So to join one or many fuzzy sets, we normally going to use these fuzzy connectivities using the fuzzy propositions like disjunction, conjunction. That means in order to get something like a correlation. Okay, something like a correlation, convolution in signals and systems. We have various relationships on the fuzzy sets to get some values, which is the outcome based on the operations we normally perform, based on the applying propositions on these particular fuzzy sets. And we have got one fuzzy rules that is called the power and flexibility of simple if-then-else logic rules is enhanced by adding linguistic parameters. That means here, if temperature is very cold, then stop air conditioner. If temperature is normal, then adjust air conditioner. If temperature is hot, then start the air conditioner. So these are the various operations which is performed based on the if-then-else logic rules. So such descriptive linguistic letters or a format can be used to represent the fuzzy sets or fuzzy operations. So fuzzy rules is expressed in the form of a simple if-then-else statements, as if variable is yes, set, then action. Okay, so these are the certain rules we normally use in defining the linguistic fuzzy parameters. Then the point of discussion here we have is control systems. So a control system is normally an interconnection of various systems to perform a specific task, where the output is usually going to get controlled by the feedback system, is basically going to be the definition for a control system. So there are two types of control systems. One is going to be the open loop control system, as we already know. Another one is going to be the closed loop control system. So the examples of open loop control system are going to be what now? Say for example, automatic washing machine. Is an example of a open loop control system. And a printer machine is going to be an open loop control system. Say for example, another example we can think of is going to be the microwave oven is going to be a open loop control system. That means here the air conditioner nowadays, we are getting air conditions with fuzzy logic. So there also we normally going to have the fuzzy control systems. So that for control system, air conditioner control system is making a decisions actually based on the temperature of the room. So therefore it comes under closed loop control system. So in the case of open loop control system, we spoke about an example like automatic washing machine. Once the programmer is going to set all the parameters, then one after the other in sequence, the fuzzy system or a fuzzy control system is normally going to enable one system after the other system based on its time duration, and the system is normally going to execute all the processes in the entire washing machine system. So that type of system is simply going to be a open loop control system. That means what, the activities will be simply going on based on the configurations set by the programmer or a user of the washing machine. Same thing is normally going to be the microwave oven. Based on the programming settings we perform, we do accordingly, the food is normally going to get heated up in the microwave oven. So coming to the air conditioner, programmer is not going to set anything. So based on the temperature of the room, based on the temperature of the room and humidity in the room, the AC is normally going to change its level of air condition applied to the room. That means the operation of compressor is totally based on the temperature of the room, which will be sensed by the temperature sensors. So therefore, that type of control system is simply going to be a closed loop control system. So that kind of control systems we can normally form by using the fuzzy control systems as well. So a fuzzy control system is based on definitely a fuzzy logic. That means this control system is normally going to implement the fuzzy logic. That means it is normally going to process multi-valued variables, where the destination or the desired results usually going to be either yes or no. Between that, there are going to be multiple values. Say for example, I want to switch on or I want to switch off the air conditioner. So when I have to switch off the air conditioner automatically, it is totally based on the various conditions. Whether air condition has to be switched on, switched off, in a stipulated time, whether it has to be switched on continuously, whether it is going to be switched on with very minute AC levels. Okay, so all those conditions, prevailing conditions are going to exist there. So all of them can be done. That means multiple values are normally been used to operate a system. So therefore, we can incorporate a fuzzy control system logic inside such a air conditions. So a fuzzy control system is based on definitely a fuzzy logic. See, any fuzzy control system is normally going to based on the fuzzy logic only. If any control system does not based on fuzzy logic, if it is based on the binary logic, then obviously it is not going to be fuzzy control system. So fuzzy control system is normally going to have a fuzzy logic. So the process of designing fuzzy control system can be described using the following steps. Now, how do we design a fuzzy control system? There are five important steps that we should keep in mind before we go for designing the fuzzy control system. First of all, you have to identify the principal inputs, desired outputs, and process tasks that are required. Identify the various linguistic variables used. Linguistic variables need not be with a linguistic language kind of thing. It could be any value, any descriptive value. So identify descriptive variables, descriptive in the sense physical variables like pressure, temperature, okay, so on and so forth. Displacement, velocity, all these are linguistic variables, temperature. So identify linguistic variables used and define fuzzy sets and memberships accordingly inside the system. Use these fuzzy sets and linguistic variables to form some procedural rules. Compulsorily, there should be some set of protocols which will be operating on these fuzzy sets. Then determine the defuzzification method. So that means what, after we first of all we identify the inputs, outputs, and the task need to be performed, and after that we convert these exact values into the fuzzy variables. After we get exact values, we perform the operations on these fuzzy sets. That means second step is fuzzification, third step is operations on the fuzzifications, fourth step is normally going to be defuzzification. Then after that, test the system and modify if necessary. So ultimately, the result should be given to the end user. So end user has to test the performance of the system. So for this, compulsorily end user is going to give a, you know, the descriptive data or a linguistic variable. He is going to expect descriptive data as the output. Therefore, this testing is done at the user level. Once user is satisfied, then the system is normally going to get developed based on these findings. Now, what could be the control system which we can think of here? So here in this particular thing, an open loop control system has been given to us, where the user is nothing but the observer of the fuzzy system. So here this system is going to take the input values for human interface. Say for example, a fuzzy system is doing the speech processing. Then in this case, what happens? Human voice is being taken as the input, and these values, human words are converted into the fuzzy values. And after converting to fuzzy values, fuzzy sets are going to get formed. And the membership functions will be simply defined based on the fuzzy rules for a particular thing. Then we get a fuzzy data. And this fuzzy data is simply given to the machine interface, which is normally used to process the signal or a system. So that means this is what your actual controller, this machine interface is going to be called as a fuzzy controller. This fuzzy controller is normally going to perform the operations on the fuzzy sets. And after that, it gives the fuzzy values. And here, defuzzification has to take place for an instrument to understand these particular crisp values. Because instrument understands only the descriptive value. Say for example, you want to control the speed of a motor. So to control the speed of a motor, what is given to the motor? The shaft movement, the displacement of shaft has to be given to the motor. The displacement is nothing but the crisp data. So fuzzy values are totally related to the programming by using the fuzzy logic. So this has to be once again reconverted into the crisp data. That is called machine interferable language values. And once again, same values, whatever has been given to the machine, machine is going to do some process. That means it is going to give some output. That output is simply once again re-transmitted back to the user to the output section. Once again, it is going to perform, crisp values into the fuzzy values, and this machine is going to process the fuzzy values, and once again defuzzification takes place here, and the crisp, the exact values are once again given to the user. So user is normally going to observe the results. Now based on the results what he observed, he is going to change the functions or implementations used in the machine interface developed by using the fuzzy logic, which is a generic, most primitive control system known as open loop control system. In a closed loop control system, we normally going to have a feedback, which we already know. So that we discuss in the next session. Next session, we discuss about a closed loop control system. In this session, we'll end up our sessions with a open loop control systems. So how do we model a fuzzy system, a fuzzy control system? So fuzzy system modeling can be pursued using the following steps. Choose the relative input-output variables. So same as the one which we discussed earlier. These are the fuzzy control system steps. So almost all same steps once again. Choose the relative input and outputs. Determine the number of linguistic terms associated with the input and output variables. Select the specific type of fuzzy system. Now it is application-based. So first two are going to be most primitive types. First of all, we choose the relative input and outputs. After we choose, then we determine the number of linguistic terms associated with the input and output variables. Then select the system, fuzzy system. If it is a temperature sensor, one type of system. If it is going to be a robot movement that's going to be another fuzzy system. If it is going to be a motor movement, another type of fuzzy system. So like that, we have to select a specific type of fuzzy system, design a collection of fuzzy if-then rules, then to formulate initial rule base, input space is divided into multi-dimensional partitions, or multiple valued signals, functions are variables, and then actions are assigned to each of these partitions. Then what are the limitations of fuzzy systems? Fuzzy systems lack the capability of machine learning as well as neural network type pattern recognition. So whatever neural network scheme or a pattern it is going to follow, you have to compulsorily preload it. So it cannot really form its own neural networks while the fuzzy system is normally going to start operating on the data. Therefore, it lacks the capability of machine learning, so and the as well as neural network pattern recognitions. So it is predefined. Once again, the machine learning operation is also going to be predesigned, predefined. So if it is programmed based on that, it cannot define its own instructions, and based on that, it's simply going to perform the task. Okay, whatever it is inbuilt already, based on that only is going to build the information on that. Okay, verification and validation of a fuzzy knowledge based system require extensive testing with hardware. So this is what one of the limitation here. Verification and validation of a fuzzy knowledge based system require extensive testing with hardware, because fuzzy systems are normally go with multi-valued variables. So therefore, extensive testing with hardware is really a tedious task, where verification and validation is also going to be a critical time-based operation in the case of the fuzzy systems. Now, next one is determining the exact fuzzy rules and membership functions is a hard task. Now, it is very hard to define the exact membership function for a particular application. So definitely there will be some error in the approximation towards getting the exact value. Stability is an important concern for the fuzzy control. So achieving stability in fuzzy control systems is a very important task. Okay, because the fuzzy systems are going to be definitely stable system, definitely not going to be a so stable systems. So achieving stability is a major limitation. Now, where we normally use the fuzzy systems? Automatic control systems in the industries, we use fuzzy systems. Predictions, diagnostics, and advisory systems, we normally going to use the fuzzy systems. User interface and neural language processing, we use the fuzzy systems. Domestic appliances and embedded systems. Soft computing and hybrid systems with artificial neural networks. So whenever we have to deal with the soft computing, we normally use the fuzzy systems. Soft computing means what? It is totally programmed version of defining the self-defining the particular task for a particular event which is going to take place. That is what soft computing. Very large-scale integrated microcontrollers, we can use fuzzy systems, and fuzzy expert systems, fuzzy inference, we can use the fuzzy systems. So these are the various applications of the fuzzy logic, which we normally prefer, where we prefer the fuzzy control systems or fuzzy controllers. Okay. So thank you very much for the today's session.